Welcome to the Artist Review. Today, we will be interviewing Mark Bradford. We'll go over some of his famous pieces of art that he's done so far. And here comes Mark now!
How's it going, Jax? It's great to be here.
We're happy to have you, Mark. Now, this is live TV, so try not to swear. For once.
Okay. I'll try my best. I don't think that should be a problem, though.
Haha, that's great. Well, first off, for those who don't know you as well as I do, tell us a little bit about yourself.
Well, what do you want to know, exactly?
Everything!
Oh, let's see, where do I start? I was born in 1961 and raised in L.A. by my mom. I never really had a father figure in my life. I usually just spend the time hanging out at the salon shop that my mom ran.
So you're 46?
53, actually.
I'm sorry, my math is a little off. So, you're 53? You only look 26.
Yeah, I get that a lot, actually. A lot of people think I'm half my age.
So you're married then, right?
Nope. Not married, no kids.
Interesting. Well, we better get on to what everybody's waiting for. Would you like to tell us about your work, Mark?
Well, as you can see, my work is very abstract-oriented. I tend to endeavor to make the appearance of my work to be very grid-like, grungy, urban, and whatnot.
And why is that? What were your, what do they use nowadays? Your influences?
Well, where I grew up, I had a lot of influence over me. Growing up in Los Angeles, I found myself segregated as a black child. There were white neighborhoods, and then there were black neighborhoods. We were never really exactly treated as well as the whites, and we struggled. That's why I included the grid-like look, as if it's an aerial view of the crisscrossing blocks and the cutting streets of LA. This is also why I made it grungy and urban. To show how degraded and run down it is in black neighborhoods. I don't think the US is doing too much to change this, and it's my opposing values on this issue that I express throughout my work.
Oh, wow. Were there any big possible worldly influences growing up as well?
Yeah, actually. Of course, the Civil Rights Movement and the Vietnam War also applied to this.
I see. Now, what would you call what you do?
I guess I call it collage and décollage. It's adding to the work and taking from it to make it look how I want. I oftentimes use paint and glue clippings to it, and sometimes even incorporate embroidery.
So who else was doing this? Just you?
No. Someone who actually helped me guide me through all my stuff was my mentor I met in 1993, Daniel Joseph Martinez.
Now tell me, Mark, what do you think of art, and what does it mean to you, personally?
Art means a lot to me. I mean, always as a kid I loved art. I would always make signs and posters and whatnot to advertise my mom's store. And I also love making home movies. Of course, as a young black kid in southern Los Angeles, I didn't think I'd get anywhere with art, but look where I am now. I mean, my passion for art is so strong, and I feel like I can connect with other people through my work. I can express ideas which turn viewers can interpret. Art, no matter in what way, shape, or form, is simply beautiful.
So what exactly makes your work unique? What sets it apart from everything else?
My work is unique because it's personal. I do it for myself, not for others. I make it branch off from my life. Aside from that, there hasn't really been a style similar to mine.
Well, thank you for your time, Mark, but we're going to have to end the show here. Thank you, Mark. Thank you, viewers, as well. Until next week, where we interview the renowned artist, Nicole Greener. Good night, everyone.
Good night.